Hi, I'm NASA astronaut Kate Rubins, and I'm visiting the Smithsonian today to talk to you a little bit about my career path and how I got to be an astronaut. My educational path is kind of funny because when I was growing up, I wanted to be an astronaut, a biologist, and a geologist. I thought you could do all of those three careers at the same time. So the first one I studied was actually biology. I went to UC San Diego for undergraduate, and then I got my PhD at Stanford Medical School, and we were studying viruses, how the virus interacts with the immune system. So I actually had a research lab, I had a group of researchers, and we studied viruses in Central Africa, as well as in a biosafety level 4 lab. I was doing that for a long time, and then I applied to be an astronaut. I actually filled out a job application online, and NASA called and had me come down for an interview. So I took a job as an astronaut after a few years of working as a researcher. So some of the previous jobs that I've had, actually, when I was in high school, I spent some time working in a clothing store. So I went and cleaned out all the dressing rooms and I folded the clothes. I also spent a little bit of time, I learned how to do graphic design when I was working on our high school newspaper. So my advice to middle school students is start thinking about the subjects that you like the most. What's really fun for you? What's things that you like to do that you don't feel like this is too boring or you don't get too upset about doing homework? If you ever get really involved in a project, you start thinking about history of the Middle Ages or some kind of writing assignment, or you love your math or your algebra class, pay attention to that because that's something that you might want to do as a career. If you find a school project that's really exciting, think about where you could take that, how you could do that as your job. So one of the reasons that it's important to be able to communicate well, no matter what field you're doing, you want to be able to talk to other people about that field. So for example, we're flying into space, but it's really important for us to come back after we fly into space and to tell people about it. We want to tell people about the discoveries that we're making on space station. We want to talk about the kinds of science and the kinds of research experiments that we're doing. So you can be a really good science experimentalist, but you also have to be able to communicate your results and your discoveries to people. So I have definitely experienced failure. I would say as a scientist and a researcher, you actually have a lot more failures in your experiment than you have success. And that's the process of science, is that you've got a question, you don't necessarily know the answer, but you set up your experiment to look at what the answer is going to be. And since you don't know how to get to that answer, your experiment may fail a few times. We actually expect the experiments in our lab to fail maybe 10 or 12 times before they work. Sometimes, when those experiments are failing, we actually learn a lot of new and interesting things. So when you're failing in a scientific investigation, sometimes you're actually succeeding more than you would think because you can learn something new.